Do you remember our previous example in which we dropped a cursor? And when we dropped a cursor, all the values were changed to match the timestamp of the cursor. Well, we did that with a for next loop. We did for a for next loop through each of the objects in the symbols collection. We can do that same thing using a construct called a for each. And the way we do this is we make use of a variable that's defined as a certain class ID. See, it's this two-step procedure. The first thing we do is we dimension a variable to be an object that is the class of the type of object that we're going to be rotating through. In other words, if we're going to be rotating through a collection of displays, we would dimension this variable as a display. In this case, we're going to be looping through a collection of symbols, so we're going to dimension this variable as a process book symbol type object. Now, once we've got this variable, we can then do a for each construct in which we say for each variable name in the collection of symbols, do a loop. And what will happen is for every one of the objects in that collection, we will repeat that loop only once for each object in the collection. And as we go through that loop, this variable takes a reference to each of the objects in that collection. Let's take a look at what it looks like as we step through the code. Here's the code that's associated with that example. As you can see, I have defined a variable called SMBX to be of type process book object library symbol. It is defined to be an object that is the same type of object that is in the symbols collection in this display. Now, because this variable is of the same type as this collection, I can do a for each statement. We're saying for each SMBX in that symbols collection. And what this means is we're going to start at the beginning of the symbols collection, and SMBX is going to stand for each symbol in turn as we rotate through that. So if I press F8, as you can see, SMBX has no value now. If I press F8 again, SMBX currently has a value. In fact, I can look at the type of that symbol, and I can look at anything else I'd like to look at for that symbol by drilling down through this variable now. So SMBX stands for the first symbol. We're going to check to see if it is a value. It's a pi value object type. That's a constant in process book. And in this case it is. If it is a value, then we do the set time range again. In this case, we're setting the time range to be, again, the null string is what we're passing for the start time, and for the end time, we're passing the time that was returned by the drop cursor. If you recall, when I execute a drop cursor returns new time. So I set the first symbol that is a symbol value type symbol. I set its timestamp, and I do this over and over again for each timestamp we find, or for each value we find. Now in this case, I have a symbol that is not a value, that's a trend. I recognize that number 10, so we don't set its timestamp. We do this for each one that is a value. And we'll repeat that over and over again until we get through the entire collection of symbols.